Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
The preparation for summer placements just start right after we get a shortlist. It's roughly around one and a half months before the D-Day. You get a shortlist, you get to know that, okay, you have these shortlists. Series of buddy calls happen where you get to know more about the firm, more about the culture, more the set of people. And along with that, in tandem at campus, you make case groups. You solve a lot of practical cases of different types of different, you know, business problems. I started off with my first interview. It was a case round with a principal, and it went well. But then they gave me a break for 15-20 minutes. They said that, you know, take your time, gather your thoughts again. Then another round of interview happened with another manager. It was another case round about an infrastructure project. And then I was sent to another principal round, where she asked more about, you know, she talked more about HR questions. She asked questions about my traits, what I like, what kind of projects I've done, what I've done in my previous, during my work experience. The most trickier one was the partner round, the final round, fourth round. So it started off with, again, a general understanding of the business, of what I've done so far, how my rounds have been, and then moving deeper into why AT Kearney. My project was peculiar in terms that I had to optimize the cost for 5 different plant locations. And that's why I have to travel every week to different cities and places, from Jharkhand, West Bengal, Gujarat, and many other places, right? So it was very hectic, right? 4th day into the internship, I was sent to the client location and independently sent across that, okay, this is your module and you have to work on it. And there was no hand-holding. So a few of the key learnings during the whole experience was that there's no hand-holding. You have been given a real project where you have to actually deliver something. Right, it is overwhelming in the start. It is a little jittering in the start, I would say, honestly. But then as you go along, as you push yourself, you get hold of the questions. Overall, the consulting experience is very sinusoidal. And that learns you how to maintain your tranquility and, you know, how to be poised in all the situations. So that was one good key learning out of it. And never take no for an answer. There's always a possibility to solve a problem in one way or the other. Taking complete ownership of the project, that's number one. Number two is keep trying, keep pushing yourself. So there were weekends over which I worked, because I had to, some of the times you have to redo work, right? You don't get the right information from the client. There's a lot of external dependency in the project, right? So never give up. Utilize whatever resources available in your near vicinity, right? So there would be associate, there would be SBAs and, you know, other people, manager in your team. Take complete leverage their knowledge and their understanding of the project. Number one is their expertise in operations domain and cost transformation, which is primarily my area of specialization over here as well. Number two would be the culture. It's a very good fit, you know, very welcoming culture. And third thing, I would say, you know, good growth, good trajectory. So early into the career, they give you international opportunities as well. Be consistent in your performance, right? And that should be a general attitude in life.